In some fields like law or finance, the school you go to actually matters. Like where you do your undergrad or even grad school sometimes matters. Does it matter for an engineer? Does it matter if you go to an Ivy League school versus if you go to some other school that just does okay in terms of your future prospects? I'm looking at it from the standpoint of someone who wants to study engineering and you're thinking about what to do.
Yeah, I see that trend actually, right, from many students and also parents also, and everyone is biased to Ivy school top 10, top.
Yeah.
So it's not in general, you know, it's the I know the admission from these schools are, you know, tough, and the process, that's they make it.
Yeah.
And because they have been there for many years, they have their reputation already, but not necessarily that. Like I said earlier, someone has to, at the end of the day, that person should solve problem and show. Doesn't necessarily graduating from X school and Y school. Then what can you do after that? After you graduate, what have you done? You'll be evaluated based on what you can accomplish, whether you are industry or in academia. What have you contributed and what did you show?
Yeah.
And people we can judge it. So, people are biased. Yes, it affects when you apply for job placement and application. The key is that what you can do.
What can you do? So, to that point, is it actually more impactful to focus on being self-taught?
Self, absolutely.
Maybe learning from online sources and some other non-traditional sources.
Yeah, I encourage self-learning, self-taught as a key, because you can go in your own pace, teach yourself, and fill in what you need. But this doesn't replace the regular teaching, because the regular teaching, there are some component of enforcing you know? That kind of enforcement is also good, because otherwise, the way you test, you have to do assignments and project and things like that, and you should be graded. That way you are qualified and certified. So self-learning plus this some kind of certification or exam is a good way, I guess.
Is it important to have the regular learning to an advanced level? Like, do you need a master's degree or a PhD to basically get very good placement in the job market as a mechanical engineer, electrical engineer, chemical engineer, and all that?
Not necessarily. Actually, some jobs, they may not need PhD. You
Okay.
may be called
Overqualified.
overqualified to it.
Yeah.